Good morning, everyone. It is Chrissy from Knittin in the Heights. Today is actually February the 13th. Oh my goodness, in October, no less. Anyhow, today I am having a non-work day. Gabriel is already off to school. School bus driver was here. Not just on time, but a little early again. I just feel so good to regular life is back. I am making my breakfast right now. I am making some Irish oats I basically flavor them with a little bit of maple syrup, put in some raisins and some pecans, with a little bit of vanilla extract. I pretty much eyeball everything but the actual ratio of oats to water. So I'm making that, and I'm catching up with Martin from the Knit365 blog. I have a doctor's appointment later. I found out they ran out of the vaccine for me, so I just rescheduled my appointment. I don't want to feel sick too often, so I rescheduled it for a Saturday. That is before a Monday. I have another day I have to take. I have a doctor's appointment. This is pretty much done. I'm just going to go to my chiropractor today, and I'm going to be trying to get in touch with Gabriel's pediatrician. If I can get him in today too, we'll do that this afternoon. So it's just going to be a lovely kind of relaxed day. I will eventually get dressed. Well, I'm in the elevator, and I just finished my chiropractor appointment. Oh, that was rough. I didn't hurt until I came in. He found a huge knot in basically my right buttock. So that we were trying to work that out. Anyway, I'm heading to lunch.
In the heart of Times Square is the Palace Theater. This theater, now currently under renovation, has been around for over a century, and it has hosted a number of great actors like Richard Kiley, Lauren Bacall, George Hearn, and Keith Carradine. In the 1950s, an acrobat fell to his death during the middle of a performance at this theater. Since then, many have seen his ghost swinging from the rafters and then screaming as he misses his mark and plummets. Just a few blocks away from the Palace Theater is the New Victory Theater. This theater originally opened in 1900 and was originally known as the Theater Republic when it was built by Oscar Hammerstein I. There is a ghost in residence at the New Victory Theater. Her name is Mrs. Leslie Carter, and she was once a leading lady of the American stage and a silent film actress. She died in 1937, but her presence is still felt in this beautiful theater. She even helps some of the theater staff when things go missing in the theater. There's a story of her actually helping them find a missing bow tie that was needed for the next show.